Hey nerds, welcome to our Play or Pass series. I'm your host, Joe Tweeden, and each week I pick new titles from the Xbox Game Pass Vault, take them for a spin, and give you my first impressions on said title. And at the end of every video, I leave you with a stamp of Play or Pass. Guys, welcome to Myst. It's a graphic adventure puzzle video game designed by the Miller brothers, Robin and Rand. It was developed by Cyan Incorporated, published by Broderbund, and initially released for the Macintosh for the computer platform in 1993. In the game, players travel via a special book to the Island of Myst. Now guys, holy nostalgia. This ain't the Myst we're familiar with. No. This is the brought back to life version of the original Myst from 1993, folks. I remember playing this on my Windows 95 PC, and it originally came out for the Macintosh, aka your Apple computers of the day. Guys, it's still, this revamped version is still from the same guys, the same company, Cyan Incorporated, that made the original Myst and the follow-ups to it, Riven, and all these sequels. What's cool about this, though, is that original game used to be a point-and-click system. This is now fully realized in the Unreal game engine, like 3D. They took the original Myst and made it available in VR and on regular game systems and PCs in essentially 3D. Guys, can't wait to check this out. These will be my burning thoughts. Guys, you know the drill. Let's get to it. Whoa, puzzle randomization. Select your puzzle solution preference. If you're new to Myst, we recommend selecting Classic. You know, we're going to do that anyway for nostalgic reasons and because I don't know what we're getting into with this revamped version, so let's do that. Oh my god, whoa.
I realized the moment I fell into the fissure that the book would not be destroyed as I had planned. It continued falling into that starry expanse of which I had only a fleeting glimpse. I've tried to speculate where it might have landed, but I must admit that such conjecture is futile.
Oh my
Still,
goodness.
Questions about whose hands might one day hold my Myst book are unsettling to me. I know my apprehensions might never be allayed, and so I close, realizing that perhaps the ending has not yet been written.
Oh my gosh. Push the left thumbstick forward to move. Okay, this movement, guys, this was not a thing. When the game came out in 93, you would take the mouse on and keyboard. You would use your mouse and circle around like this, but we didn't have the 3D. Oh my gosh, this is wild. Like, I'm acting like a kid that's never seen a modern video game. But, no, seriously, we were not able to walk up to things like this. You had to point and click at things. Yeah, I mean, you would move the mouse around the screen, click on it, and then it would move to an image that was closer to the book like this. But so far, audio, the characters, the character talking, that's exactly how the original starts. Let's open it up. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. This book is in like a three-dimensional space. Like, look at this. I can look around the Book of Myst. What? Say what? Okay, you guys don't understand. In 1993, this was like a boom. This is all you get. A flat image, and you can, like, click on it to go to it. This is so wild. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I'm afraid to move the stick. Oh my gosh. Guys, I just... I wish I could explain or describe to you. To use the menu button on your controller to open the menu. I wish I could explain to you why this scene right here, this scene right where I stood, boom, right here. I wish I could explain why me being able to do this, just looking to the side and looking up, is wild for the game of Myst. Because guys, Myst was not a 3D explorable world like it is now. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. I'm trying not to be biased, but like this. Okay, for instance, you would do this. You would be like, oh, you look down here, and it's all because from right here, you'd move the mouse down over here, and you would click on it. Now, the image wouldn't move. The mouse, the cursor would move across the screen, but you would still be staring right here. And you click, like, on that thing up there, and it would move you quick like this, like, instances of this. I mean, go Google videos on the original Myst. You guys will instantly see the difference, but, like, wow. Things like this, you would, like, look at this switch, and you'd be like, oh, crazy. And then you click away to look, like, to go up there. Everything was like, ah. Okay, best way to describe it, guys. Don't know what that did. We'll see, huh? Best way to describe traversing through Myst in the original game, the original version, was like Google Maps, like Street View. You go to Google Maps or Google Earth, you go down to Street View, and then you would point and click, and you would shift and move forward to the next area of the street. That's exactly, more or less, exactly how it was. But like being able to 3D, three-dimensionally walk in this world, and the fact that they used Unreal Engine is just like, oh my gosh, can't believe it took them 20 plus years to do this with Myst. I mean, Myst is, I'm not one of those guys that's like, oh, don't change what we love. Like, I'm down for seeing new versions of things we love and for introducing new generations to this, you know? But see, like, it would take forever. You would click on that, and you'd be like, okay, what did that do? And you'd see, like, I clicked on that down there. What did it do anything? Okay, I'm gonna stop trying to be so reminiscent, guys. Running. Wow, there's running in this, which makes amazing sense. Okay, both switches are up. I haven't seen indicate. Okay, so we're going to get to, we're going to get down to the actual gameplay part here, guys. We're going to talk about how things are currently. I needed to express my nostalgia for just a minute. Hold on, let me go down real quick. Okay, something interesting about this game, though, is you stay in running mode unless you click off of it, so that's cool. This, though, can we interact with this? No? Oh! I don't know if it's because of the switches we hit or if I just hit the red button and that did it. Don't know. Have no idea. I don't know what that means. I really don't. I don't remember some of the puzzles in this game. It's been so long, guys. So far, everything looks how it was intended, but like, okay, I'm just, sorry guys, getting past the nostalgia, let's try to enjoy the puzzle aspects in this new version. Let's get to it. Okay, we got A, B, D-pad, change selection, R and L, push interact, and L. Topographical extrusion test. Marker switch diagram. Water turbulent pool. Oh, okay. Confused. Oh my goodness. Here's our first, like, puzzle thing. 6-7. I don't know what the right code is. Honestly, I don't. Okay. Oh, D-pad, there we go. Yep, we gotta find a clue. Tropical extrusion test 40, Marcus Stokes diagram 47, triple turbulent pool 67. I don't know, just clicking on either of these take us there? No. Nope, it just takes us to that test. Okay, let's look around here. That's the thing, guys, is that this has a deep story to it. I mean, deep or not, the puzzles are extreme. Like, there's a lot to the puzzles in this game. Okay, that doesn't do anything. Oh, man. And the thing about the original Myst is you had to have a notebook with you. Because the way, I don't know how this game is as far as keeping notes. Hold on, let's check out the menu. Oh, we can save game. Well, that's cool. Let me hit save. Empty slot. Nice. But that seems about it. Okay, I saved it here. So it's going to load me here if I ever need to reload. But, oh, interesting. Okay, we might have to come back here later. Because I'm not getting any more clues just by pressing these buttons. I can hold it down, but that doesn't do anything currently. And the thing with this game, with the original Myst, and I'm sure this holds true with the revamped version, there's just a lot of very intricate puzzles and mysteries. So I think a lot of people will enjoy this game for that, and especially in this modern take, like with the exploration thing, like the free movement in this world, I think our younger generations will really be able to get into this nicely. There, I did a third switch again and nothing new happened. What's over here? Nothing here. Running, walking, nothing new. Just trying out different buttons here because I'm not sure. Okay, we're running again. Oh, here's like a replica of the sunken ship, I'm guessing. Okay, that's one symbol. Let's activate all these and see what happens. There's a spider, or beetle rather, an anchor. What's on this one? I'm guessing a snake. An eyeball. We're gonna say just a bird, not sure what kind. Cross. Leaf, arrow. Okay, I'm not sure. Let's turn this on. So far, we've turned on all those symbols, and we keep flipping the switch. Let's see what else is over here. Let's look around. Oh, this is a switch too. I'm just gonna keep flipping switches that I see and look around and be like, anything happen? Anything new? Something down. Ooh, it's a cave system. Okay, let's go down here. Let's walk because I feel like running is a little jolty and a little too much, you know. Gosh, there's a lot going on here. And oh, what I was saying earlier is like you had to keep track of notes in the game. Like there wasn't like a system or a menu. Let's see, power to ship and generator switches 1 through 5, 6 through 10. The power and power to ship look the same, don't they? They look the same to me, guys, don't they? Ooh. So, oh wait, okay, so power to ship is straight to the left. I don't know what that means, but let's see what we can do. Oh. Okay, hold on. Are there numbers associated with this? What's the indicators? We needed to get, I guess we power those up until the arrow is straight left. Kind of makes sense, so let's try that. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, oh. That is a sequence it didn't like. Let's try this. This goes up 9. 28, 55, 71, 79, 86, 90. Oh, interesting. We get right to 99. There must be an indicator of how to do it, because 1 is 5, and that's 21. So what if we go, that's 25. So 10 plus 2, I don't, Oh. Those two make 11. Okay, so where's the, what's the clue? Let's look at this a little, let's look at this for a second. What is the clue? We got 1 through 5 and 6 through 7. And we need them, I'm guessing we need them to be aimed to the left. I don't know. Let's. Putting them all on makes it go to 99. Okay, so what's another one? Let's go reverse. All of it's 90. Is the sequence, is there anything that affects the second one? August 99. Okay, we need to get out of here. This has been interesting, but like we need to look a little further into the game. We need to find other details about this, you know, that aren't, I don't know, crazy. Like, that's the whole thing. There's so many puzzles and clues in the game. Left, right bumper to rotate. So, there's gonna definitely be a time spot. Huh. I don't know. Okay, what does that do though? Did anything happen? Okay, it doesn't move. The hour hand doesn't move. Okay, so that does not specifically help. Wait. Oh, let's try that again. Let's go down one. Did that work? No. I figured aiming those two that the same direction as that might do something, but maybe not. Right, let's keep looking. Let's look for other clues. Let's see. We keep getting these switches. I'm just gonna keep flipping them. Yeah, until something happens, I guess. Okay, more clues. More. Well, puzzles, rather. Okay, well, I don't know any combos. I don't know the combo yet. We're gonna find something somewhere. I know, we're gonna see what happens. Is that going up? Am I crazy or is that going up? Oh my goodness, okay. Let's go. Ooh, what's over here? Let's explore this for a hot second. We have all these switches on. I don't know what it's gonna do. Well, shoot. Can't go in there. We need to start finding some numbers. I don't remember enough of this game. It's been so long. Read a few of these clues here. Let's see. Oh dear, what just happened? Okay, that looks like it's gonna take me somewhere else. Oh, here's an overhead map. Oh, hey, what is this? Oh my goodness, I remember this little switch. Oh. So I aim this at something that whatever I want to. Oh my gosh, I forget. Okay, let's leave it there. It's aimed at the ship. Oh, and I remember the fireplace. Oh my gosh, I remember that too. The blue book, the red book. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness, so much reading. I'll read just a couple excerpts here. I have called this age Channelwood, and it is a very different world. Though it is exactly how I imagined it, it is still amazing to see it with my own eyes. Water covers this age as far as I can see, except for a small rocky island. Elsewhere, there are only trees which grow directly out of the water. A myriad of thin wooden passageways are built just above the water, and disappear into the forest. I assume they were built some time ago, for they appear aged. I'm eager to discover more about this land and its people, but I have arrived here late and I must rest. I was awakened this morning by strange noises coming from the pathway adjacent to the one on which I had slept. I saw a group of monkey-like people heading in my direction. They had not seen me yet. I did not feel threatened by their presence. Their response to me was one that I would have never expected. After staring at me for a short time, they fell to their knees and began what appeared to be some sort of ceremonial worship. Oh my gosh. 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 They are ready for travel alone. For now, I must give my farewells to the creatures, for I do not know how long it will be until I visit this age again. And, friends, that's going to conclude this. There's like 10 pages. I'm going to pretend to look here and just see. Oh my goodness, look at that. Oh, the symbols. Here we go. Man, I mean, look at this, guys. I forgot. It's been a long time, but a lot of the clues are in the books, and it is relatively important. See, there's partial writings that are missing. And look, look this. This is something that you didn't. It didn't save in any journal. You had to jot these down, and I'm. If the game stays faithful to that. Oh, and here's an overhead map. If the game stays faithful to that, I reckon there's no modern version. Yeah, look at that. Stairs. And I remember this had to do with, like, two different brothers, I think. Oh, yep. Indicators of... Oh, yeah, back in the day, you guys, we had to take well, when this game came out in 1993, we didn't have cell phones to take quick pictures. I know. Sounds like I'm aging myself horribly, but, these sequences. I remember my aunt had this game on the computer, and she wrote dozens of notes. Took pictures. Look how many sequences there are. Look at this. Holy crap. Oh my goodness, I don't know if there's a point to any of these, or if there's an end. I truly don't know if there's an end to this, hold on. I'm so curious, but I don't think there's an end to it. I think it's randomization and an endless number of pages, because there's no way that there's a need to remember any of these. I don't... Oh my gosh, we almost got to 300 pages.
Wow.
Okay, and I remember lots of clues here. Uh-oh. Oh dear, what's this gonna do? Oh my gosh, the grid. Oh man. I'm totally making this up. Hold on. Yeah. I didn't think it would do anything. But there's like there's like 100 plus pages in that puzzle. Like, what? I forgot the complexity of these puzzles, man. Alright, guys. I am going... Oh, my goodness. We could be here for hours trying to figure this out. Oh my gosh, look at that. I made it in. Oh, here's another thing, another sequence of things. Okay, guys, so here's the thing. My hot take. Guys, this is wild experience if... Specifically, this is a wild experience if you're someone who played the original Myst or its sequels, and if you were a kid or a teenager when you did. Because, like, coming back here now in my mid-30s and checking out what they did to this thing, this is so cool. But on a more realistic note, I would like to point out that this has a very complex, wild amount of puzzles to it that are just kind of unheard of in the modern puzzle platformer today, and it is worth a look. It's definitely worth a check out. Guys, it's on Game Pass. I'm going to give this game a full stamp of play. I would continue gushing about it, but I will just bore you guys with my words of nostalgia. Leave a comment down below and tell me about your experience with Myst and its franchise. Guys, thanks for watching. As always, nerds, I'll see you on the other side.